بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Now moving on to the fifth type or the fifth way an amr can be used. As I said, not only these five or these seven or nine, it's in a book, about 25, 30. It's just a matter of zawq and understanding and appreciating how it is. He's one, he's giving his tahdeed. What does tahdeed mean? In Arabic, basically tahdeed is called what? To threaten. When you threaten somebody, you say haddadahu. When you khawwafahu wa tawa'adahu bil uquba, when you like threaten him, he's going to be punished. And another name for this is also called, other books, some books have it as tahdeed, and some books label it as wa'id. Okay, both mean the same, a threat. Now what happens here? You're given an amr when you really don't want amr to happen. You're given an amr, a command, whilst in reality you don't want the command to take place. Okay, for example, Allah says, i'malu ma shi'tum. Do what you want. So you can't use this to say, well, Allah says in the Quran, i'malu ma shi'tum, whatever we wish we can carry out. Anybody understand that? For example, let's say your mother, your father, well, Allah got really angry with you, do what you want, I don't care. So, wow, wicked. You're going to start smashing the kitchen. You say, Daddy, I can do what I want. Everybody understands that that's not what is meant. So this i'malu ma shi'tum, it doesn't mean amr, you have to carry out what is, that Allah says, do whatever you wish, you have to carry out. No, it's opposite meaning actually. And the context will tell you this, that look, i'malu ma shi'tum, Allah is saying this, that look, you don't want to listen? i'malu ma shi'tum. And there'll be context before it, after it. They show you that, look, if you do what you want, فَإِنَّ مَصِيرَكُمْ إِلَى النَّارِ. You'll see what happens in the hereafter. Okay? So, normally, in Amr, is what? The mutakallim was a mukhatab to carry out something. Here, even as Amr, it's opposite meaning. Adamur rida bil ma'mur bihi. The mutakallim does not want the mukhatab to do that action. That's why he's expressing it in a, like a frustrating, obviously for frustration doesn't apply to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but in an angry or a warning, in a warning sense. Okay? For example, come in the hadith. Look. Inna mimma adraka an-nasa min kalam an-nubuwati al-nubuwa idha lam tastahyi fasna' ma shi. So inna, so he's saying here that from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that what has from the nubuwati ula, meaning certain messages and certain things that the earlier prophets taught still exist today. And one of this is what this saying, idha lam tastahyi fasna' ma shi. If you no longer have haya, then do as you wish. So again, fasna' ma shi, not saying that go and do what you want. He's saying, when you no longer possess haya, then that's basically the root of deen. If you don't have haya and modesty and you fear that Allah is watching me and I got to answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then do whatever you want. Okay? Yeah? Make sense? Another example. فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Okay? So whoever wants, bring him, whoever wants, doesn't matter. It's up to you. But then obviously, there's consequences. So from the context, you can tell that it's not an amr. It's what? A tahdeed. Yeah?